there haven't been a whole lot of guides recently teaching you how to play Zenyatta, and many people have lost touch with the new ways you should play him within Overwatch 2. Instead of rehashing the old Zenyatta guides I have made in the past though, let's instead discuss how you should be going about playing him in ranked today. Zenyatta has been the main hero I've played at Penn State for the past few years, earning many top finishes and even wins with the team as well. Even when he is not the hard meta, there are ways to play him that are unconventional but truly allow you to carry games. While Zenyatta is his own standalone character, a lot of the concepts we will discuss can be transferable to other supports, so keep that in mind throughout today's guide. In order to really pop off as Zenyatta, you first have to understand how you should be playing differently based on the team you are playing around. Understanding the speed of compositions, or the tempo, is crucial in order for you to play at your max potential. In the past, Zenyatta has been played primarily along spam-heavy characters, including Sigma, Widow, Hanzo, Ashe, and Baptiste. In this scenario, Zenyatta fits the glass cannon stereotype clearly. He wants to stay in a rather safe position, poke down the enemy's shield, and deal efficient damage alongside his team. This works out well on maps that have really long sightlines, like Havana and Circuit Royale, but what happens when you start playing on closer maps like King's Road, Nepal Village, and the list goes on? This is where the much more modern style of Zenyatta is played, typically around characters like Wrecking Ball, Genji, Tracer, Sombra, Brigitte, and even Ana. In this situation, Zenyatta is not scared that he is a glass cannon. Instead, he utilizes it to make an aggressive composition that finishes fights nearly instantaneously. While I have already made videos explaining this composition, allow me to lightly explain the concept. In the Wrecking Ball matchup, typically the team wants to surround the enemy in a circle through taking multiple angles as opposed to stacking close together and fighting the enemy as a core unit. This allows for the Zenyatta to take extremely punishing angles, finding discords on virtually any target and taking them down quickly. This can all bleed together though, so in short, the first misconception you have to get out of your head is that Zenyatta should play far away all of the time. The way you should be playing is all based on your composition as well as the enemies, not all the way in the back. Now we will discuss a concept commonly referred to as ping-ponging. Just because you should be more aggressive on Zenyatta doesn't mean that you're invincible and not susceptible to being killed quickly. You are still a glass cannon, and your understanding of how to play around this has to be pristine. For example, if I am playing Zenyatta with a friendly ball composition into an enemy Winston composition, I have to be very careful. If they can jump onto me easily, I will die faster than I can call for help. In order to counter this and play the comp to my best, I need to ping pong. Much like the sport, I need to recognize their dive and live, or see the ball they are serving to me and then receive it. The moment I recognize that I have lived the jump and they have no way to get out, I then shift the flow of the fight and walk in with my Brigitte or Ana into the Winston and the rest of his team, dealing lethal amounts of damage and defeating the enemy. In ping pong, this moment would occur at the exact moment I receive the ball, hitting it on my paddle. If the fight prolongs, the same ping pong principle stands, back and forth until we win. Ultimates can make this concept pretty difficult to understand, but the most important thing to get out of this for most of you watching this video is the basics. So please rewatch this section and ask questions as needed. It is a really difficult concept, and if you don't get it right away, don't beat yourself up about it. Now that we have learned the specifics of his tempo though, let's discuss the rest of the intricacies of Zenyatta's kit through his primary and secondary fire. Perhaps the most misused ability within Zenyatta's kit is his damage and how you should be using it. There are situations where single shots are better, just as there are situations where charging up shots is better. Primary shots should be used when you are actively in a close to mid-range duel with somebody. For example, a soldier just turned a nearby corner on you and you cannot get behind cover. These shots should be used for shield break if and only if your team has a shield covering you as well. If your shield is broken, you will have to charge your shots from around a corner. Primary shots are precise, allowing for you to deal more pinpoint damage, but they can be much harder to hit. Secondary shots will be used in many more situations. Typically, they are used in rotation to a new position, launching volleys on different angles to possibly find a pick, but more importantly, picking up some ultimate charge. Another situation we have already mentioned was to break shields if you don't have one up while you wait for your team to make the next move. This is common when playing a ball composition into a possible Sigma composition. Lastly, the volley can be charged behind walls until you are ready to fire, adding a burst of heavy damage before you take a 1v1. All of these tips seem really small, but trust me, it makes a huge difference. Charging your orbs in front of someone's face gives them time to react and counter you, but when you use them in these situations correctly, you'll be amazed at just how much more damage you will do alongside all of the other eliminations you can pick up. Now that we have discussed his primary fire, let's discuss his primary healing option. The first step people need to take with all of his ability orbs is to simply get them on someone consistently. People tend to forget about Harmony Orb because the healing is lower compared to other supports, but trust me when I tell you it makes a huge difference. Once you stop forgetting, however, it is important to think about a few more deeper level things. Just because a Harmony Orb is efficient doesn't mean it's effective. What does this mean? Well, let's think about the ball composition with Ball and Tracer. Typically, they are going to play together and then rotate in tandem. While the Tracer may be squishier, who is going to be taking the bulk of the damage within this duo? Most likely the Ball is going to, while the Tracer takes the slim to none. While orbing a Tracer is more efficient, orbing the Ball here is much more effective as he is the one that is more likely to actually need it. Then when the fight breaks out and you and your Brigitte are deterring their dive, you give the orb to your Brigitte because she is the one that needs to be more aggressive in order to keep you alive. This is the same idea that was used back in the GOATS meta in Overwatch 1. God, I'm old. Zenyatta would keep his orb on Reinhardt at all times, not because it was the most efficient, because he is the one that will be needing the healing the most. Obviously, this is super situational, as in ladder you will almost never get a perfect composition, and people will also not play correctly all the time. Use this knowledge, however, to scope out the rest of your team and attempt to understand who is taking the most damage and who really needs the healing, not who would get the most efficient use out of it. Genji's taking duels, Reinhardt's leading a rush, and supports getting dove are all great options for your Harmony Orb, but the context of the situation matters. Moving on to his other orb, the Discord Orb, players have a much better grasp of this one. However, it is very easy to get carried away with your own duels. Make sure that you don't get too selfish and keep it on a target that no one else is shooting for too long. You want to place the Discord on a target that people can actually shoot and follow up upon. Discording an Echo that just left spawn while the team is fighting on point does not help anyone. You're essentially out of the fight if you do this. Building upon this concept though, if you know a target has a key ultimate, you can focus them down with Discord to force it out faster or kill them before they even use it. For example, if the Winston has Primal, the Genji has Blade, or the Lucio has Beats, all of these are good targets to force out early as it will allow your team more options to win the fight since the enemy is being forced in an uncomfortable situation. This is especially true if the enemy Zarya or Sigma has ultimate and you do not have Transcendence yet, as you will lose the fight easily if they are not dealt with early. Arguably the more important thing, however, is to just call who your Discord is on. Now I know what a lot of you guys are thinking. No one ever joins chat. Within my experience, most people do join voice chat, they just don't talk. That means they are at least listening. I urge you to simply join voice chat and communicate who your Discord is on and where they are if they are in a position behind cover. This could be as simple as Winston Disc or on a disc back of point. This ability is pretty simple and comes with a lot of practice, but it is easy to get off track and autopilot on the wrong targets. So think about how you should be enabling your team and balance that with how you can enable yourself as well. On to our last tip of the day regarding Zenyatta's ultimate Transcendence, there are a lot of misconceptions with the ultimate. First off, Transcendence should not be used as an engagement tool. The team should already be engaged if you are using it this way. If you use it to walk in, you lose out on about 2 seconds of value at least, giving you only 4 seconds to really do anything worthwhile. A lot of the concepts you can get out of the specifics you can find within previous guides on the channel, so let's make sure you take away these next two concepts. When you have your ultimate and they don't have any big ultimates to counter, understand that you can play to take really aggressive angles in the mid-fight you otherwise couldn't since you have Transcendence. You'll find that you can win some engagements because the enemy does not realize that you are playing in a weird position, further snowballing your team's momentum. Lastly, it may seem silly, but make sure every time before you use your ultimate that you're discarding an enemy target. At first, it doesn't matter who it is, but as you grow, think about ultimates they may have or are building you will need to Transcendence for. For example, if the enemy Sigma is present within the fight, you can discord him and burn him so you have a better chance at building another Transcendence before he builds Flux. This is a niche example, but I find that a lot of players do not think about Zenyatta's ultimate in this manner, which can cause a lot of people to lose out on otherwise winnable games. So if you were to take anything away from this video, understand that Zenyatta is played in an aggressive manner outside of spam compositions. If you want to climb a Zenyatta, you need to understand how to control the game with his kit and keep the fight in your hands with your damage. Enable your team by thinking deeper with each ability with solid communication. If you found value in today's video, consider giving the video a like or subscribing to the channel. If you are watching this video close to its release, I am likely currently streaming an unranked to GM with Zenyatta only. If that is concluded, you'll see a card at the top of your screen for a recording if you're interested. Otherwise, thank you all so much for watching, but until next time, I've gotta peace out, and Paz out. I'll see you in the next one.